The staircase also incorporates the restroom blocks of each story. Now we're going to create its partitions. Let's return to the floor plan to add some partition walls. Double-click the Wall tool in the toolbox to open the Wall Default Settings dialog. Display the Geometry and Positioning panel. Set the wall top offset to -200. Select brick plastered both sides for the wall composite. Set reference line to outside face. Display the model panel of the dialog. Make sure that the side surfaces are set to paint 1. And adjust the edge overwrite to surface stucco. Select the interior partition layer from the list. Click OK to close the dialog. We are going to place a vertical partition wall at the side of the stairwell. Zoom in to the stairs. Click on the right side of the window above the stairs. Click on the edge of the bottom horizontal wall while holding down the Shift key. Zoom in to the upper end of the new partition wall. Please note that the connection of the composite walls is incorrect. The connection of construction elements and composites in all model views are determined by the building materials intersection priority settings. When building materials with unequal priorities intersect, the element with the higher priority will remain intact in 3D and will be in front in 2D. The element with the lower priority will be cut and the intersected part removed. We will modify the building material used by the brick plaster both sides composite wall. First, select the newly placed partition wall and the horizontal external wall on the floor plan. This will help to identify which building materials are used in these walls. Choose Options, Element Attributes, Building Materials. Building materials used in the selected walls are highlighted and checkmarked in the left column of the list. To sort the list by selection, click the icon in the top left corner. Check the intersection priorities of each building material. Please note, brick, structural, has a higher priority than concrete block filler. Sort the list by name and locate brick structural in the list. There are two more brick type building materials available with lower priorities. We're going to change the middle skin of the composite brick plastered both sides to brick. Select brick in the list and change its intersection priority to 520 in the right-hand side of the dialog. Click OK. Select the partition wall only. Right-click and choose Edit Selected Composite in the context menu. In the list of skins, click Brick Structural and choose Brick from the pop-up list. Repeat the same with composite brick plastered one side. Modify the brick structural skin to brick. Click OK. Please note that now the connection of the external wall and the partition is displayed correctly. Important: we have to modify the composite structure and the building material intersection priority in the main file too, so the wall appears correctly. Next time when you open the host file, please repeat the same changes. We'll place one horizontal wall at a distance of 697 mm from the intersection of the newly placed partition and the external wall. Zoom in to the upper right area of the stairs. Move the cursor to the intersection until the cursor changes to a check mark. Type Y and 697 minus, and the cursor will jump downward 690 mm. Press Enter to start creating the wall. Change the reference line to inside face and complete the horizontal wall. Zoom out. Select this wall and drag a copy downwards 2,844 mm. Use the Move, Drag a Copy command from the context menu. Move the cursor to the upper edge of the inner concrete wall. Click on the orange dot. The resulting guideline will help us to create a 600 mm long wall. Click on the intersection point of the guideline and the vertical wall. Change the reference line location to outside face. Move the mouse towards the right on the guideline and type 600 in the tracker. Press Enter to create the 600 mm wall segment. We would like to close the right side of the passage. This wall will be at a distance of 5,800 mm from the vertical concrete wall. Move the cursor to the right bottom endpoint of the vertical concrete wall. Type X 5,800 plus in the tracker and press Enter to move the cursor to the desired position. Press Enter again to start creating the wall. Change the reference line location to inside face. Create the wall to be of equal length with the existing vertical wall. Hold down the Shift key while using the smart cursor to define the endpoint of the wall. Finally, we'll create a short wall section from the right corner of the window in the middle to the bottommost point of the vertical wall. Open the Wall Default Settings dialog box. In the Geometry and Positioning panel, choose the brick plastered one side from the list. Display the model panel of the dialog. Apply Paint 1 for Edge Surface Override. Click OK. Zoom in to the lower part of the floor plan. Click on the right corner of the window. Click on the endpoint of the wall while holding down the Shift key. Select the new wall segment and a mirror copy of it using the midpoint of the window to create a similar wall segment in the opposite corner of the window as well.